హాయ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ద వీడియో లెక్చర్స్ ఆన్ టెక్నికల్ సి. బై శ్రవణ్ కుమార్ మంత్రి. అండ్ ఇన్ ఏ సిరీస్ ఆఫ్ లెక్చర్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ కంప్లీటెడ్ 100 మల్టిపుల్ చాయిస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇఫ్ యూ కన్సిడర్ ఫర్ ద ప్లేస్మెంట్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ. అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ ద కోడింగ్ పార్ట్. ఇన్ దట్ కోడింగ్ పార్ట్ టిల్ నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ కంప్లీటెడ్ 4 డిఫరెంట్ క్వశ్చన్స్ విచ్ ఐ హ్యావ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ విత్ సొల్యూషన్. లైక్ ఇఫ్ యూ గో టు ద ఫస్ట్ వన్, దిస్ ఇస్ దస్ cells arrangement. The second one, this is we call it as Pythagoras triplet. The third one, printing Armstrong numbers. And fourth one, printing Fibonacci prime series alternatively. All these questions with coding and explanation you can watch in my previous video lectures, where it is titled as Technical C Coding Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, Part 4. Now we have to see the question number 5. So from now I want to deal with the questions which are related to arrays. So some of the programs which are related to arrays I want to deal. After that I'll go for the questions related to strings, then I'll go for pointers, like that. So if you consider for arrays, I want to deal these things like basic operations, what is traversing, insertion, deletion, reversing, update, search and sorting. Then I want to go for these sort of the programs which are related to arrays. So one by one we have to see all those things. Before entering into arrays, we'll see first what is an array. Of course we know that this is a basic, like it's a collection of homogeneous data items. That means let us consider a situation where you want to store the subject marks, a particular subject marks. So if it is a single subject and it's for only one student, I'll create one variable s1. If it is for two students, I'll create one more variable, that is S1 for first student, S2 for second student. One more student if I want, like this, I can take. Let us suppose if there are 10 students, I might take S1, S2, S3 up to S10. What if there are 100 students? For the same subject marks, I want to store for 100 students. How to take? Is it possible to create S100, like 100 number of variable? Is it flexible? So definitely creating 100 variables is a complex thing. So that's why what we need to do is I want to create a one variable and where I'll take the size as 100 here. So this is we called as an array, where it is a collection of 100 elements. This S is a variable which is a type of array where it can store 100 values which are of same type. So like, let us suppose if I write int S of 100, I can give S of 0, S of 1, S of 2, S of 3 till S of 99. Anyway, index starts from 0. That's why 0 to 99, totally 100 elements I can store. If there are 200 students, simply I'll keep here S of 200 here. Like this I'll do. So this is a flexible one. I'm taking only one variable, which is a type array. In that I'm storing all the values of a particular subject. That means 100 student values of a particular subject in each index. So like this I can store, and also it is sequential, that's why, so I can traverse them easily and I can retrieve whichever I want easily. Whatever the operations I want to do, I can do easily here. So this is what the basic thing like array. So it's a collection of homogeneous data items. Why homogeneous? Means if I take it as int, all 100 elements values should be integers. If I take char s of 100, all alphabet must be, all symbols must be characters. So if I take float, like this, float s of 100, so all 100 values must be floating point numbers. So like this you'll have for arrays. And C provides two types of arrays. One is fixed length array and the other one is variable length. So here it's a fixed s of 100. I can store maximum of 100. I cannot store more than 100 values here. So if I want to store more than 100, I have to change the length of this. This is we called as fixed length or fixed size. So variable length array, that means it might change according to the input. So that is we called as dynamic memory part. So anyway, we'll go for this problems which are related to arrays and how you can initialize. So you can write a variable of with the size. Here you have taken 5, no, this is size, so 5 elements you can enter here, and this is the one option. Of course this is we called as basic initialization. where you are giving your input internally, that means inside the program. So here also this is another type where you are not providing the size, but here you are providing the values. No, how many values are there? 5 values, that's why. So totally 5 values you can store here. So here you have written numbers of, here also you have written. So how it will store means the array that is numbers of 0. So anyway, index starts from 0, that's why 0 is 3. Next numbers of 1 is 7. Like this it will store. So numbers of 3 is 24, 4 is 45. So you can provide the size here, you may not provide the size like this. So what about this one? 5 I have given, 5 elements, but here I have given only 2 elements. What about the remaining 3? By default they are zeros. And what about this one? If I give the size is 1000 and I have given 0 in the initial, only in the 0 in the braces. That means all the 1000 values are initialized as zeros like this. So this is initialization of two all zeros. That means bulk number of initialization with 0, if you want, you can provide like this. So this is what, and remember, if I give instead of 0, if I give 1 means what happens? Only the index 0 will have the value 1, other remaining all are zeros, similar to this one. So this is what the initializations when you consider for arrays. Now this is also one simple program you can observe. How you can, what is the output of this one? You can observe array of 0 I have given, array of 1 I have not given, array of 2. So simply I'll take this one, how it will store in memory. Array of 0, that is 5, array of 2, that is minus 10. Now you can see array of 3 by 2. What is 3 by 2? Generally we say it is a 1.5, but it is 3 and 2 are integers, that's why you can take only the quotient part, that is 1. So array of 1, what is array of 1? 2. Now array of 3 equals to array of 0. You can assign like this. What is array of 0? 5. 5 will be assigned here. So like this you can assign the values and you can print here. So you'll get the output, that is 5, 2, minus 10 and 5. So like this it will print as output. Now we'll see the questions. The first one, what is it? Traversing the printing all the element array elements one by one. Traversing in the sense, whatever the elements you have given input, that has to be printed. So we'll see that one, how to print that. So let us suppose if I give these elements are as input, I have to print those elements only. You can see that traversing, printing all the array elements one by one. So how to start? Anyway, I'll start here. First I require an array, that is A of, I have taken the size maximum of 100. You can increase this, but in general I have taken 100, maximum of 100 values I can consider. I require one variable I. I require n is for size, I is for traversing each element. So first of all, what I need to give size of the array, this is the maximum size here, but how many elements you want to take? Anyway, memory is allocated for 100 elements, but I don't want to use 100, I want to use only 6 elements, let us suppose. Now your n value, the size has to be given 6. So here n value it will take as 6. Then what are those elements I need to enter? So that is enter the elements. So how to enter? That means the first value, you can see here, scanf %d ampersand of a of I. What is I value? 0. So a of 0. So a of 0, you are entering first element, let us suppose 30 if you enter. So that will 30 will be stored in A of 0. So then it will ask for the second element. Let us suppose if you enter 20, 20 will be stored in the A of 1. Why? Because you can see I plus plus. So like this till n. That means I starts from 0, I till less than n, it's not equals to. That means 0 to, if n value is 6, up to 5 it will take. So 0 to 5 means totally 5 values. Remember here it is not equals to, here only less than. So you can see here, totally 6 elements means 0 to 5 only it is considering. So now you have taken all those elements. That means in when you execute, it will ask for enter the size. You are entering the size, how many elements you want, and what are those elements, you enter those elements. Now you want to print each element. What is your logic for printing? So the given elements are simply the same, taking the same thing. Here I starts from 0, where you are printing each element A of 0. A of 1, A of 2, everything. So one by one you are printing simply. This is the part where you are giving size. This is a part scanning each element. And this is a part where you want to print whatever the elements that are given. So this is about how to traverse each element one by one in an array. Let us suppose if you want only one element, let us suppose if you want to get only A of 4, simply you printf %LD A of 4, you can get the answer. So if you want only individual element, you can print separately. If you want to print all the elements, you have to put a for loop here. So that's it. So this is simply the printing the array elements one by one. So the basic program. Coming to the question number 6, insertion. So inserting an element in an array in a particular index. First we'll see an example here. Let us suppose this is an array where the elements are given as like this. Totally the size is 6. Now I want to insert an element. So where I want to insert first and what is the element, both are required. Let us suppose I want to enter element 50 at the position, I'll give it as 3. Remember, position is 3, that means 1 2 3. Third position means the index value is 2. Let us suppose if it is a fourth position, the index is 3. Fifth position, index 4. Sixth position, index 5. That means nth position means index is n minus 1. Remember this point. Now I want to insert 50 at position 3 means index is 2. So here I want to insert 50. So now what is the resultant? 30, 20, here it is 50. Now after this, this 40 should be moved here. This 60 should be moved here. This 90 should be moved here. Now the array size will increase by 1, where I will insert the last value. Previously the size is n, now the size is n plus 1. Remember these points. So how to do this one? What is the logic? So you might find that, so first I will insert 50 here at A of 2. Let us suppose if I insert 50 here, now if you want to search for the value 40, where it is available, so that value is removed, that value is replaced. So this is a problem that we'll get when you consider first if you insert. So what is the logic we'll do here is, whatever the last element is there, that I'll insert in the n plus 1 position. That means this is a n minus 1 position, I'll insert it n. So 80 will be moved here, 90 will be moved here, 60 will be moved here, 40 will be moved here. So everything is arranged. Now you can observe, whatever the element, new element I want to insert particular position, now I'll insert. Now you can observe all the elements are successfully arranged. That means insertion happened and then successfully I have changed the positions of the next elements. So this is the logic I'll follow. The first thing is I'll move the elements to the right, then I'll insert the element whichever I want to insert. So this is the logic I'll follow. Let us see that logic in terms of program. So anyway, first I need to consider the size of an array. That is the same thing. I've taken array of 100 and I'm giving the number of elements, that is size. Then I'm taking what are those elements. Simply this is scanning the elements. Now asking for where I want to insert the location, that means a position. So where I want to insert 3, no? So that I want to give here, the variable is position, ampersand position. Now the value also to be given, no? The 50. So enter the value to be inserted. So value also I have given. So now in our example, the position is 3, value is 50. So now we need to insert. Position is 3 means index is 2. Remember this point. Now you can observe the logic. So first I starts from n minus 1. So n minus 1 means what is n value in our example? 6. Now 6 minus 1, 5. So you can see from 5 till the position minus 1, till the position value is 3. 3 minus 1, 2. That means till this. So starting from 5 up to 2. You can observe what I am doing here. Array of I plus 1. I value initially 5. 5 plus 1. So array of 6 is equals to array of I. That means 5. What is there in 580 will be moved to array of 6. You can see here. This is the index 6, no? 5, 4, like this. So now whatever array of 580 will be moved to here, array of 6. So 80 came here. Now next, again loop goes, I decremented, now I value 4. So array of 4 is equals to array of 5. So next, array of 4, so 4 plus 1, array of 5 equals to array of 4. So what is there in 4? 90 will be moved here. Similarly, the next value, array of 3 plus 1, 4 is equals to 3, that means 60 will be moved here. Next, 40 will be moved here. Now I value is equals to 2. Okay, so 2 plus 1, array of 3 is equals to array of 2, that is over. Now I value is equals to 1. When comes to I value is equals to 1, 1 is greater than or equals to 2? No, then it comes out. So when it comes out, you can see array of position, what is position? 3. 3 minus 1, 2. So array of 2, what is there in array of 2 actually? Array of 2 is also 40, that has to be replaced now, is equals to value. So I kept that as 50. So now you can observe. So resultant array is, you need to print. And one more thing you need to observe here, I starts from 0, I less than or equals to I have written. Why means, now the array size is increased by 1. That's why I starts from 0, I till equals to the size is 6 in our example. That means 0 to 6 means totally 7 elements I have to cover. You can observe here, starts from 0 till 6. So the index 6, all the elements will be printed. So like this, we need to find the logic. This part is giving the size, this part is giving the elements, this is entering the position that you want to insert, here the value you want to insert, here the logic where you want to transfer the elements to the right side till the position, and entering the value at the position, so finally printing. So this is about inserting an element in an array. Now coming to the deletion. How to delete an element at a given index? Let us suppose this is an array. I want to delete an element. Let us suppose I want to delete 20. So what might be the resultant one? Here you will get 30. This 40 has to come here. 60 has to come here. 90 has to come here. 80 has to come here. Now what is the logic to be followed here? So in order to delete an element at a particular index, particular position, what I need to do? Here it is very simple, like whatever the next element is there, simply moving front. That means 40 if I move here, 20 will be removed. 60 if I move here, 40 will be removed. Like this, one by one, if I move like this, so the element 20 will be removed and the size of the array will be reduced by 1. So previously the size is 6, now the size is only 5, where the index starts from 0 up to 4. So this is what, and we'll see how to write the logic for this. Anyway, here this is the same thing like I explained in the previous video lecture. Enter the size first, how many number of elements that you want to give, that is n value. In our example this is 6. And what are those elements I want to enter here? You can see, so y till n, up to n. So you can see total elements I entered, no? 30, 20, 40, 60, 90, 80. Now what is the required one? I want to get the location where I want to delete an element. So that is I am giving with the position. And here also remember, position is 2 means index is 1. Remember. So second position means index is 1, third position index is 2, fourth position index is 3. Like this I need to consider. So in our example the position is 2 I need to give. So if I give 2, that means I need to delete at the index 1. So this is the logic where you can observe. If position is greater than or equals to n minus 1, that means let us suppose the size is equals to 5 here. The size is equals to 6 here. Let us suppose if I have given the size is 7. Let us suppose if I have given position is equals to 7. I want to delete at position 7. Is there any position 7? No. So that means if it exceeds definitely you can say that deletion is not possible. That means we need to enter the position value within the range. So if you give greater than, so it will print as deletion is not possible. Else, of course, it is within the range. Let us suppose. Then what I need to do? So I'm just going to the position minus 1. Let us suppose position is 2. If I given, I'm directly going to 2 minus 1. So till 1. That means if I give position is equals to 5, I have to directly go to 5 minus 1, 4. I need to go and I have to move front all the remaining values. So here you can see. So I equals to 1, I till n minus 1. Now you can see a of I. So a of 1 is equals to I plus 1, a of 2. So what is there in a of 2? 40 will be moved to a of 1. Next increment. 60 will be moved here, 90 will be moved here, 80 will be moved here. What is there in a of 5? Anyway, 80 will be there. But what we'll do here is, instead of printing all those 6 elements, I'll print till this one, till this. Why? Because this is repeated. So I have to print only till 4 index. So now you can see I equals 0, I less than. So if I want to print all the elements, I have to write n. But if I want to print n minus 1, 1 less. Why? Because the size is decreased by 1. You can see I equals 0, I less than n minus 1, I plus plus. You can observe it will print only 30, 40, 60, 90, 80. So this element I am not printing. So this is what we can do, how to delete an element at a particular index. Coming to the question number 8. So reversing an array, here we can see printing in reverse order. Reversing the elements in an array, reversing only first half. So what is the difference here? So if you consider this array, printing in reverse order means only to print the last element first, like this. That means 80, 90, 60, 40. 20. Like this you need to print. Here the thing is, the original array A will be as it is. Here we are not changing the array, we are just printing in reverse order. That is the first one, printing in reverse order. Reversing the elements in an array, that means you have to reverse it. That means A of 0 should consist the last element, that is 80. A of 1 should consist this one, 90. A of 2 should consist this one, this one, this is 60. So like this you need to arrange. So this is, we call it as reversing the elements. That is the main difference in the question A and B. In A, array will be as it is, only you are printing reverse. Whereas in B question, you are reversing the elements in an array. If you print the array, it has to print whatever the reverse of an array. Now the third one, reversing only first half. So if I divide into two parts, this is the half. First three elements, only I want to reverse this. So that means the resultant should be like this. So 30, 20, 40 means 40, 20, 30. It should be printed as it is. 60, 90, 80. This should be our resultant array. So like this you have three questions which are with respect to reversing of an array. So we'll see all these three questions with explanation. Coming to the first one. Printing reverse order. We'll see what, how to reverse and how to make it in reverse order. We'll take an array here, okay, and we'll take the variables I and n. N is used for the size, number of elements, and whereas I is used for to scan each element in an array. So for I equals 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So you can see here I equals 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So like this you can consider. Then scanf, where you want to scan each element in an array. Now how to print in reverse order? What is the logic that you need to follow? So very simple, what is the logic to be followed is, I will take first the last element to be printed, next the last but one. So here you can observe, what is the index of the last element? If I take 6 elements, let us suppose n is equals to 6. So what is the position of the last element? Definitely n minus 1. Why? Because it starts from the index 0 to n minus 1. So first I will have to print n minus 1, next I have to print n minus 2, next I have to print n minus 3 till 0. So this is the logic that I'll follow. So you can observe here the logic. So the reverse order is for I equals to, what is I initial value? N minus 1. Let us suppose if I take n equals to 6, I value will become 5. That means what is there in A of I? First I'll print, then A of 4, then A of 3, like this till up to 0. So here I greater than or equals to 0, till the index 0 you need to print. You can observe here, and it should be a decrement operator. Every time you are decrementing the I value, so you can see just printing the value I equals to n minus 1. That means n value, if you take 6, A of 5 will be printed. Next, I value decremented to 4, that means A of 4 will be printed. Next, A of 3, next A of 2, A of 1 till A of 0. So this is the first one, that is printing in reverse order. Here you can observe, even if you print, what is this array A of, if I starts from 0, I less than n, I plus plus, if you print the array, you will get the original array, not the reversed. Now coming to the next one, that is reversing the elements in an array. So this is the logic to be followed. Here you can observe, till this everything is same, till this, if you compare with this, that means this is the scanning of the number of elements. Here, what are those elements to be scanned? Now, after reversing, what happens, you can observe. So how to reverse? What is the logic that I'll follow? I'll show you with an example. So reversing means 30 should go here, 80 should come here. Is it right? Like this, 20 should go here, 90 should come, 40 should go here, and 60 should come here. Now, is there any need to go for the next? No. That means if there are 6 elements, only 3 swappings I'm doing. So this is the logic. That means if I have n number of elements, n by 2 swappings are enough for us to make it in reverse. So that is the logic I'll follow here. That means A of 0 I'll take will be swapped with A of n minus 1. A of 1 will be swapped with A of n minus 2. That means if I value is 0, j should start from n minus 1. I should be incremented, j should be decremented. And I'll make it swap till I is less than n by 2. Is it right? So this is the process I'll follow. Now if you observe here, you can see for I equals to 0, j equals to n minus 1. Remember here only comma, not the semicolon. These two are initializations. Then semicolon, this is a condition, I less than n by 2. Here 2, that is one is increment, another one is decrement. So here also comma. Now you can observe I value is 0 initially, j value is n minus 1. If you take in our example 6 minus 1, 5. So temp is a variable I have taken. Temp equals to A of I equals to A of j equals temp. If you use this, the values will be changed. You can observe temp equals to A of I. What is the value? 30. Let us suppose A of I is equals to A of j, let us suppose 80. So A of j equals to temp. What is there? 30. So previously A of I we have 30, A of j has 80. Now after this you can see A of I is 80, A of j is 30. So this is, we know that general swapping with temporary variable. So like this it should be done. After this I is incremented, so I value will become 1, j is decremented, so j value will become 4 in our example. So A of 1, A of 4 will be swapped. Like this till n by 2 you can do. This is a process. And if you take odd array also, not a problem, then also it will be applicable. So after doing this, now you can observe, I'm printing the array. You can see what happens. The values will be printed in reverse order in an array. See, if you observe here, in this example, if you print the array, if you see the array, I starts from 0, if you see the array will be the same like original. After this execution also, if you print the array, the original array will be printed. But here, after this process, if you print the original array, you will get the reverse array, the elements which are reversed. That is the main difference here, printing reverse order and reversing the elements in an array. So this is the logic to be followed. Now coming to the third one, reversing only first half. What you need to do here, instead of taking, that means only first half, that means instead of taking n number of elements, I have to take n by 2 elements. That means your j value should be half only. So this is the logic here you can observe. So I starts from 0, j should starts from n by 2 minus 1. So why n by 2 minus 1? Let us suppose there are 6 elements, 6 by 2 minus 1. So 6 by 2 minus 1, which is 3. So first 3 elements, that means 0 index, 1 index, 2 index, only these 3 I'll swap. Is it right? Totally 6 elements means first 3 elements. So like this, this has to be swapped. And I less than their half n by 2 here. Again half of this n by 4, can I say? Yes. So I plus plus and j minus minus, and here you can see I equals 0, j value will become 2. So 0 2 will be swapped like this, and 1 will be as it is anyway. So if you have more than, let us suppose if I take 10 elements, so half is 5, no? So it should start from 0 to 4. So 0 4 will be swapped, next 1 3 will be swapped, 2 will be as it is, the index 2 will be as it is. So this is what happens in the concept of reversing only first half. Let us suppose if I ask you only to reverse the second half of the elements, what you need to do? In this example, j will be as it is, I should start from n by 2 plus 1. You need to remember I should start from n by 2 plus 1, and you can observe, of course, the remaining things are same. So this is what we need to apply when the question, that means question is changed according to the question, you need to answer. So this is about how to reverse the elements in an array. Coming to the question number 9, decimal to binary conversion. So how to convert a number that is given in decimal, that is base 10, to binary, and what is, how to write a program? So we'll see now. Let us suppose I have given a number like 25, which is base 10, means decimal. What is the binary value if I ask you? So what you will do here? Here you can write like this, 25, you binary, that's why you have to divide with 2, 2, 12, 24, and what is the remainder that has to be written here? 2, 1, 2. 2 to 4, and what is the remainder? So 12 into 2, 24, plus 1, 25, you will get it. Now 2, 6, 2, 6, 12, and the remainder is 0. 2, 3, 2, 6, and the remainder is 0. 2, 1s, 1, 2, 1s, 2, 1, what is the remainder? 1. Now next 2, 0, the remainder is 1. Till you get 0, you need to proceed like this, and you need to write these zeros, ones, those binary numbers in reverse order. That means starting from here, 11001, 11001. So now you can say this is a binary equivalent for the respective decimal number. Now how to get the program, how to write the program? So what is the logic to be followed? So the logic is very simple. I'll take this as n, a number, and I will divide this, whatever the quotient I'll get, I'll replace it with n. That is, first I'll take the remainder, whatever the remainder I am getting each time, I'll store in an array. So I'm getting 1, next time getting 0, next time getting 0, next time getting 1, next time getting 1, next time getting 1, next time getting, of course, that's it. So I'll take in an array each value, and afterwards, after getting this, I have to print this in reverse order. That means from here, this one to be here, this one to be here, this one to be here, 0, 0, 1. So this is the answer. That means first thing, you have to find the remainder. How to get the remainder? Definitely n percentile 2, and I have to change n value. That means n equals to n by 2. Of course, you need to store in an array something, that is a of I is equals to your remainder value. So like this you need to do until your n value is not equals to 0. So we'll see the program now. So So first of all, I need to take a number. That is, I have taken. That is scanf percent ld ampersand n. Yeah, I am using a function called as convert of n. Okay, so I am calling a function. When I call a function, I need to write the prototype here, function prototype or function declaration. So this is a convert of n, which is a type is void, which I am not returning anything, just executing the function. Void the function name convert. What are the parameters? N only. What is the type of n? Int. So that's why I'll write only int here, putting semicolon. Like this I can do. So if you don't write, some sort of the compilers will give the error like function declaration or function prototype missing. So every time when you call a function like this, you need to write the function declaration or function prototype. And sometimes if you define the function here itself, no need to write the function declaration, directly you can define the function. Okay, and when you use a user defined function, you require three things like function declaration, function call, and now you will get function definition. This is we called as function definition, where entire block, this block here, I'll write the block of the code where this will define the function. What is the meaning of this function? So here this parameter you called as for actual parameter, this parameter you called as formal one. Now convert function. Let us suppose here I'll take n value as 25. Here also this n is different from this n. This n is local to this main function. This n is local to convert function. You can use another variable also, not a problem here. Let us suppose if I write int a here, whatever the n value here, it will be equals to a value. Here if you take n value as 100, here directly it will be taken as a value as 100. So that's why it is actual parameter. This is formal parameter. Now I have taken an array a of 50 ir. R is for storing the remainder. Now you can see for I equals 0, n is not equals to 0. So it's not I is not, it is n. It is n is not equals 0. Why I have taken this one? Till 0, till n value starts from 25, n should reach to 0. Till that I have to do this one. You can observe here. R equals to n percentile 2. You can see 25 percentile 2. What is the value I'll get? 25 percentile 2 means 1 I'll get. What I am doing that one? The 1 I am storing in a of I. What is a of I? A of 0. Here I am storing. Next, n equals to n by 2. Previously n value is 25. Now n by 2. That means 12. See, this part of the thing again I am storing in n. Now you can see. So closing, that means next I value. I value is 1 here. I value is 1 here. N is not equals. What is n value? 12. 12 is not non-zero. So that's why it goes inside. R equals to, now n value is 12. 12 percentile 2. What is the 12 percentile 2? 0. So 0 will be taken and 0 will be stored in a of 1. Like this. Now n equals 10 by 2. Now 12 by 2. 6. So this value I am storing. Now next, I plus plus I value is 2 now, n is not equals 0, r equals to 6 percentile 2, which is 0, I am storing in a of 2, n equals to 6 by 2, which is 3. Now 3 is non-zero, r equals to 3 percentile 2, which is 1, 1 I am storing in a of 3, and 3 by 2, which is 1, I am taking as n value. Now 1 is non-zero, r equals to 1 percentile 2, which is 1, and I am storing that one in a of 4. Next 1 by 2, which is definitely 0. So now n value is what? 0. N value is 0. Now it goes, 0 is non-zero, no, comes out. Now if you see, what are the values in an array? 1 0 0 1 1. Now I want to print these elements in reverse order. We'll see that logic here. I starts from I minus 1. What is I value when it comes out? You can observe. I is equals to 4 and I plus plus. I value will become 5 when it comes out of the loop in our example. Now that's why I am taking I equals to I minus 1. What is 5 minus 1? 4. So what is there in A of 4? This one. So this has to come here. So that has to be printed here. Here I am just printing in reverse order. That's it. So Here you can observe printing percent %ld AFI, which will be printed first. 1 will be printed. Next, I decremented. This value will be printed. Next, 0. Next, 0. Next, this one. So like this, if I print, this is the exact binary number of given decimal number. So like this you are printing. So this logic is very important when you write I equals to I minus 1. Why I have taken? That means when it comes out of the loop, it will come with the I value, where that is in our example, the I value will become 5. That means we stored till A of 4. That means I value will become n, and where we are storing till A of n minus 1. So this is what happens when it consider decimal to binary conversion. Coming to the question number 10, printing even numbers and odd numbers separately in an array. So let us suppose I have taken an array like this. So where, which consisting even numbers and odd numbers. So I have to take two arrays. One is even array, the other one is odd array, like this. So we have to take two arrays. One is even array, the other one is odd array, like this. So where this even array has to take only even values inside it, 30, 60, 92. This odd array only has to take odd values in it. Like this it has to print. So how to write the program? First thing, how to find whether the given number in an array is even or odd? We know that. So we'll divide with 2. If the remainder is 0, then we can say that even number. So we'll store in one array. If it is odd number, we'll store it in another array. That is a basic logic, we'll find it. And then the challenge is here, we don't know how many exactly even values we'll get and how many odd values we'll get. Maybe in, let us suppose if I take 10 elements, 9 values may be even, 1 value may be odd, or else 3 values may be even, 7 values may be odd. So like this, we don't know exactly how many values, but we'll see how we can print all those values. We'll see the logic. First thing, we'll take an array. So we are taking 3 arrays. One is source array, B is to store even so the array B is used for storing even elements. C is used to store odd elements. So we'll take variables I, J, K. J is 0 initialized and K also initialized to 0. Now I'm taking the size of an array, that is n. So it is asking for entering the number of elements in an array. So I'm giving input elements like this. So here in our example, n value is 6. The elements are like this. I have taken for I equals 0, I less than n, I plus plus. That means I'm taking, traversing each element. Now the logic you can observe. If A of I percentile 2 is 0, that means what? I'm checking for whether the element in an array is even number or not. I'm checking. If it is even, what I'm doing? I need to store in one array, that is B. So B of J, what is J value? 0. So B of 0 equals to A of I. Let us suppose if I take 30, 30 percentile to 0. Yes, so B of 0 will have 30. That is A of I. Now J plus plus, J has to be incremented now. 0, now J value will become 1. Now, else, let us suppose this is true only. Next, if I take 25, 25 percentile to non-zero. That's why it go directly comes to else part. You can see C of K. So C of K value is initialized to 0. So C of 0 will be 25. And K plus plus, K value is also incremented. So here J value is equals to 1. K value is also equals to 1 now. Now you can observe K plus plus. So afterwards, again it goes to the for loop. I value 0 over, I value 1 over, I value 2 next. 45 percentile to is 0? No. So directly else part C of k, what is k value? 1. So C of 1 is equals to 60. So like this, next it will take 60, of course even. So here B of j, so B of 1 is equals to 60. Here it will store. Like this, all the values will be stored. Now I want to print even array. So like this, you are storing. Here you will get 3 elements. Here also you will get 3 elements. So here, let us suppose I want to print even array. I should start from 0, I less than till j. Why? Because I have taken the variable j to insert the elements into even array. That's why whatever the j last value is there, till that it is storing. That means here j value will become 3. That means I equals to 0, I less than 3. That means up to 2 the index, it will store the elements. So that's why this part is very important, how to take I less than j, I plus plus. So all the even elements will be printed. What is odd array? So k value. So k stores the elements in odd array. That's why I less than k is the condition here. So till c of I. So you cannot put here I less than n, I less than n here. So if you put, that means till n equals 6, but we don't have those many elements here. So this is also one logic we need to remember. And you can argue that, like, why should I take b of j? Can I take b of I equals to a of I? If I take, the problem will be like, of course b of 0 is equals to 30, you will get here, but if I take 25 here, if I write c of I equals to a of I, c of I means c of 1 is equals to a of I. That means the 25 will be stored here in c of 1, not in c of 0. So this is a major problem you will get when you want to take separately even and odd without considering these variables. That is I, j equals 0, k equals 0. So these things are important in this sort of the logic. So this is how we can print even numbers and odd numbers separately. Now if the question is asked like positive numbers and negative numbers separately in an array, you need to print positive and negative numbers separately in an array. How to change this logic? Simply here, instead of this, what you need to do? If a of I, what is positive number? Greater than 0. What is negative number? Less than 0. That means if this is greater than 0, you send it to b of j, else send it to c of k. So this is a logic you need to follow in your example. So if you take 0 as a positive number, you can write here, if a of I is greater than or equals 0, then b of j, else c of k. So like this you can take, and here it is the array positive numbers, here the array which is negative numbers. So like this you need to change the logic with respect to the question. Coming to the question number 11, that is finding the second largest element in an array. So we'll see how to find the second largest. Consider this is an array where you have 6 number of elements, that is the size of the array is 6. Where these elements, if I ask you what is the largest, the answer is 92. If I ask you what is the second largest, that is 83. So I need to get the answer 83. So how can I get the answer? How to do all those things? The simple logic is, first I'll take two variables L1 and L2. L1 always gives the first largest, L2 always gives the second largest. So finally, if I print second largest, definitely I'll get the answer as second largest. Okay. Now L1 is initially the least value. Maybe I'll think it of 0, or else the least value in the data type. So that I have taken. So the least values I can say. Now I'll check it out with this. 30 is, I'll check it out. If 30 is greater than these two. So if 30 is greater than L1, what I have to do? Your L2 will be L1, L1 will be your 30, is it right? That means L1 is equals to A of 0, L2 is equals to whatever the previous L1. Like this I need to consider. Now if I take 25, A of 1, now I have to check it out, 25. So 25, what is L1? A of 0, is greater than 30? No. Like this you need to check it out. If it is greater than L1, I need to change like this. L1 will be your new value, L2 will be your second largest. That means previous first largest will become now second largest. Is it right? If previously, let us suppose I have 30 elements, so this is the largest. Now if I get 40, so your new value will become first largest, the previous largest will become the second largest. Now if the given one, the first thing is, if it a of your given I is greater than L1, you are doing this process. If it is, the a of I is not greater than, that means if a of I is less than L1 and your a of I is greater than L2, what you need to do? So that means your value in middle of these two. So that means definitely no need to change of L1. That means L1 is as it is, that is only the first largest. Now L2 has to be changed. L2 is changed with a of I. So that's it. This has to be followed. Like if I consider this part, 30, 25, of course, if I take 30, initially all both are zeros, that's why 30 will become L1 and L2 will be 0. If I take 25, that means 25 is greater than L1? No. L1 is 30, no. 25 is greater than L1? No. That's why 25 is less than L1 and 25 is greater than L2. What is L2? L2 is 0. So now I can say L2 is equals to 25. Now L1 is 30, L2 is 25. Now if you consider 45, what I need to get actually? 45 is the L1, 30 is the L2. We'll see. So 45 is greater than L1. What is L1? 30. 45 is greater than 30? Yes. So that's why L1 will become 45. So L2 become, what is the previous L1? 30. So like this I need to consider. Now 60. So 60 is greater than what is L1? 45. Yes. So this will become 60. Previous L1 will become your L2 now. So next 92. So 92 is greater than L1? Yes. So here this is L1 is 92. L2 is previous L1. That is 60. Now coming to 83. 83 is greater than L1? 92? No. So 83 is less than. So now I'll go to this one. 83 is less than L1 and 83 is greater than, what is that? 60. Is it right? So your L2 will be changed here. L2 is equals to, only L2 will be changed. What is L2? L2 will be only A of I, that is 83. Now you can see L1, the first largest is 92 and second largest is 83. You can observe. So this is a simple technique we'll follow and we'll write the code. So now we'll see the code. So I'm writing here the enter the size, that is scanf. You are giving the array size and here number of elements. What are the elements I'm entering? Now I will tell you why I have written here limits.h. I'll tell you. Now you can see here L1, L2, I have to take minimum values. So if I take L1 is 0, I may get it is an integer. That's why it will take some negative values also. So that is not lesser, like 0 is not lesser with negative values. That's why I need to take a least value in the data type. What is the least value in the integer data type means? That can be given by int underscore minimum. So this is the least value will be assigned. Now when you want to use int underscore min, you have to include the library header file, that is limits.h, where int underscore minimum, which gives the least integer value which is stored in the integer data type. And you can have int underscore max also, of course all are in capital. Int underscore max is also there. This is gives the greatest value, largest value in the data type integer. So when you consider largest value, you need to go for int underscore max. When you consider least value, you have to assign with int underscore min. So you can print it, you can get the answer as something like minus of, that is the least value in the integer data type that can take. So now L1, L2 values are the least ones. So for I equals 0, I less than, and I plus plus, now I am checking if A of I is greater than L1. So L1 is the least value. L1 means first largest. So if your input value 30 is greater than, yes, definitely it is greater than. That's why L2 will be L1. That means what is L2? L1. What is L1? The least value. Again, it will be like int underscore min. So what is L1? A of I. What is A of I now? 30 you will get. Now if you go here, next value, like this 25 you consider. So I equals 1, A of 1, what is that? 25. 25 is greater than 30? No. So now it comes here, 25 is greater than, Of course, this one definitely it is true. And 25 is less than 30, yes, true. That's why L2 will become A of I. What is A of I? 25. So L2 will be 25. Now next value 45, you can stare. 45 is greater than L1, yes. So that's why L2 will become previous L1, that is 30. L1 will become now value 45. Like this. Next 60. 60 is greater than L1, that is 45, yes. So L2 will become 45, L1 will become 60. Next 92. 92 is greater than 60, yes. So this L2 will become 60, L1 will become 92. Now considering the last value 83. 83 is greater than L1. What is L1? 92. 83 is greater than L1? No. So it comes here. 83 is greater than L2, 60, yes. And 83 is less than L1, that is 92. 83 is less than 92, yes. Both are true. That's why L2 will become A of I. What is L2? Will become 83. Now all the elements are covered, and now you can see what is L1, 92. What is L2? 83. So now I am printing first largest and second largest. Our answer L2 you will get here, that is second largest element, as in our example that is 83. So like this we need to follow. So this is about finding the second largest element in an array. Now coming to second smallest element in an array. So how to do this one, second smallest element in an array? So again I'll take this one. So here what is the first smallest? 25, and second smallest is 30. How can I get this one? So the same logic we need to follow which we have done for second largest, and some sort of the minute changes we need to do. So we'll see what are those changes. So in the second largest, you are checking for greater than, no, here it should be less than. Here also you are checking for greater than, no, it should be less than. And here you are checking for less than, this should be greater than. And one more thing, here you are checking for the minimum value you are writing, no. Here instead of minimum you have to take the max, int underscore max, max value to be taken. So if you take the max, then only you can check it out whether the elements, the initial elements are minimum or not. Like that you can check it out. So and here you print it as first smallest and second smallest. So we'll see that code here. So this is a part where you can enter the size and you can enter the elements. And you can see here L1 equals to int underscore max, that is a maximum value in the integer data type that can take. So that will be stored in L1, and L2 also the same thing. So here you can see if A of I is less than L1, so you can check it out. 30 anyway, initially L1 is int underscore max, L2 also int underscore max, anyway initially 30 is less than L1, definitely less than. So that's why L2 is equals to L1, that is int underscore max only. And L1 equals to A of I. What is A of I? 30. Next, 25. So 25 is less than L1. What is L1? 30. 25 is less than L1, yes. So that's why L2 will become L1. What is that? 30. And here it will become 25. L1. So next value 45. 45 is less than L1. Is it true? No. Now else if 45 is less than L2? No. So anyway no need to check this condition. And its next value it will be taking as 60. 60 is less than L1. What is L1? 25. No. 60 is less than L2? No. So next value 92. 92 is less than L1? No. 92 is less than L2? No. Next 83. 83 is less than L1? No. 83 is less than L2? No. So like this it will check the all the values. Now you can see, can I say L1, that is smallest, first smallest, L2 is second smallest. Like this you need to check it out. Even if you want you can take one more element. Let us suppose if I want to take one more element as 15. Let us suppose if I take this element, you can check for the next element. Of course, here you can observe if A of I, what is A of I? Say 15. 15 is less than 25. Yes, true. Then what you need to do? L2 is equals to L1, previous L1 is 25. Now L1 is equals to A of I. What is A of I? 15. Now you can check it out. What is the second smallest? 25. You can observe here also. What is the second smallest? 25. So like this, you need to check it out the logic and you can connect with another problems. So like this, you need to check it out the logic. So whenever you go for, and here also I forgot to write here. Yeah, here also you need to include hash include limits dot h. Why? Because here I have used that limits, that is int underscore max and int underscore max here, that is included in hash include limits dot h. You need to compulsory include when you use these things. Coming to the question number 13, that is repeated element and count. So we need to find the element which is repeated. Let us suppose if I consider this array. So if you see the elements, that is 30 is repeated 3 times, 20 is repeated 2 times. So this must be printed. So which are repeated, that has to be printed as output. And remember one point, and 30 is repeated 3 times. You cannot print like 33 33 33 like this. No, 30 is repeated 3 times, should be printed only once. 20 is repeated 2 times, that should be printed only once. So how to write this program? What is the logic that will follow? So the logic is, I'll take the first element 30, I'll check out with this next element. If both are not same, I'll ignore now, I'll check with the next. So if both are same, like this you can see 30 30 equal, then what I will do is, here the count will become 2 and this I'll make it as something like 0. Why? Because next time I want to go for finding next element, then again you will find 30 here, again you will get one more count. So in order to avoid that, I'll make this as 0. Next I'll take the next element, again you get 30, so this will be incremented and this I'll make it as 0. Now the next element 20 not equal to 30, I'll ignore. 83 not equals 30, I'll ignore. So I'll print 30 repeated 3 times. Next 20, the element I'll check, 20 with the next element, what is there? 0. So 20 with 0 not equal, 20 with 0 not equal, 20 with 20, yes, equal. So 2 times. When again, when it occurs means, then again I'll make it as 0. When it repeats, then I'll make the second number as 0. Now 20 with 83 not matching, like this. So what is the next element? 30 is over 20. Next element is, now you can find here 0 instead of 30. Now 0 is repeating thrice if I get 0, so we should not get 0. No, so actually you don't have any element like zeros here. Now what you need to do, whenever you get 0, what is the meaning? Already you have traversed that element and you have counted that, no need to count it again. So that's why what you need to do, if your array element is equals to 0, you need to ignore it, that means you need to skip it. So if I get A of 2, 0, I'll skip. A of 3, I'll skip. A of 4, I'll skip. So skipping, how can I do? By using the statement, that is jumping statement, that is continue. So after that 83, it's not repeat anyway. Last element definitely will not repeat with the next element, so I may not check with the last element. Now we'll see this code here. So I've taken the array, so enter the size, I'm taking the size of the array, then I'm taking the elements, what are those elements I need to scan by using scanf statement. I've taken all those elements. So this is the taking of input. Now see the logic. For I equals 0, I less than n minus 1. Why n minus 1? I told you, no? So the last element, no need to check with that. There is no next element. Of course, this can be same with the previous elements, but not with the next elements. If it is same with the, if the last element same with the previous elements, this I am making it as 0 now. That's why I'm going till I less than n minus 1. Now the count initially 1. Why? Because whenever you consider an element, it that means it is occurred once initially. So I equals 0, that means now I am taking here 30, the initial value of 30 is 1, that is a count is 1. Now j equals to I plus 1. What is j value? If I take I value as 0, j value is 1. That means checking like this. So j equals to I plus 1. What I am checking? Yeah, if a of I double equals 0. Why double equals to 0? Whenever you find it as 0 means I no need to check that. And I'll make it as continue. So what is a of I? 30. 30 is equals 0? No. So that's why it will go to the next here. That is if condition. If a of I equals to a of j. What is a of I? 30. What is a of j? That is j equals to I plus 1. No? So 20. So 30 equals to 20. No. So that's why it will not go to this if condition. And here it is only closed. Now again it has to go to the for loop. Why? Because for loop started here and closing here. This for loop. This for loop is started here and closing here. And this for loop is starting here and closing here. So now I equals to 0 only. J equals to incremented by 1 more. That means J previously 1. Now J value is 2. So that means I am checking with A of 0 with A of 2. So now I am checking A of 0 with A of 2. 30 equals to 30. We'll check it out. Of course, A of I double equals 0. No. So it comes here. 30 equals to 30. Yes. C plus plus. That means previous C value is 1. Now it will become 2. Then A of J is 0. What is A of J? A of 2. Now I am making this as 0. Then J equals to next value. 30 again. Again this condition is true. So that's why C plus plus. So it will become 3. Next, and again A of J is 0. Next J value 20. 30 equals 20? No. Next J value 30 equals 83? No. So that's why this J loop completes. Then it goes for I value. What is I value next? And before that, if C is greater than or equals 1, what is the C value I am getting? 3. So it is greater than 1? Yes. So that's why %LD repeated %LD times. That means A of I. What is that? 30 repeated how many times C value? 3. So 3 times it is repeated, it will be printed. Next I value. I value is 1. Anyway, count again has to start from 1. Why? Because I am checking with the new element. So that's why again count is starts from 1. And I am checking with the next element. That is I equals 1 means A of 1. That is 20. So now I am checking with 20. Anyway, C value is 1. Initially count is 1. J equals to I plus 1. So I value is 1, J value is 2. What is inside? You have 0. So A of I. What is A of I? A of I is 20. Is it 0? No. So that's why it will go here. A of I equals to A of J. So 20 equals to 0? No. So next value. 20 equals to again here 0. No. Not matching. So next 20 equals to 20. Where J value is 4. So then it will come here. I value is 1, J value is 4. So A of I equals to A of J? Yes. So C plus plus. Count is equals to 2. Now A of J. What is A of J? A of 4 will be 0. Next. Value of J will be incremented to 83. Now check it out. 20 is equals to 83? No. So then comes out of the J loop and check with C value. What is C value? 2. Is greater than 1? Yes. Again it prints like 20 repeated 2 times. This is A of I is 20 is repeated %LD. That is C value 2. Next it will go to the next value. What is that? I value is 2 here. Now C starts from again 1. Now you can check it out. What is there in the value? A of I 0. You can see. If A of I, what is A of I? 0. 0 double equals 0? Yes. Then continue. Continue means what? It will skip all the remaining statements inside the block and goes to the initial. Goes to the initial and will check it out. So like this, next A of I will check it out with this 0. Again it will skip. And next 0, again it will skip. And next value, I value 83. So now 83 will be checked, will not be checked anyway. I is less than n minus 1. So n value is 6, 6 minus 1, 5. Less than, that's why up to 4 only it will check it out. So like this it will check. The final output will be 30 repeated thrice, 20 repeated 2 times. And no need to print which occurred only once, the element 83. So this is the procedure to be applied when you want to get the repeated element and its count. Now if your array consisting of the element 0, take another thing, another value which will not occur in your, so which is a unique one, and when you get that unique one you can write it as continue so that you can skip that element. Coming to the question number 14, swap any two elements in an array using pointers. So how to swap? So we know the swapping, that is, so let us suppose I'll take this is an array where the elements are 6. Now how to swap any two elements? Let us suppose I want to take the element a of 1 and a of something like 4, a of 1 and a of 4. A of 1 is 20, a of 4 is 16. So how to swap in general? If we'll take some temporary variable, so temp equals to a of 1 and a of 1 equals to a of 4, a of 4 equals to temp, like this you will write, like what is temp? A of 1, that is 20. A of 1, what is a of 1? A of 4, what is that? 60. Here what is a of 4, which is equals to temp. Temp means now you assigned with 20. Now you can see what is there in a of 1, 60, a of 4, 20. Previously it is 20, 60, now 60, 20. So this is a procedure can be applied. Now the question is asked how to do with using pointers. Now how you can do with pointers? Of course you can create a pointer variable, or else without pointer variable also you can do. Why? Because we can say that in the concept of C, we can say arrays are one type of pointers. Why? Because if I say a of 0, I'll get 30. If I say ampersand a of 0, I'll get the address of a of 0. Let us suppose the base address something like 2000. Now even if I write, if a of a is an array, if I write what is a, if I ask you what is a, means same thing like address of a of 0, that means a is equals to address of a of 0. And similarly a plus 1 is equals to address of a of 1, like this a plus k equals to address of a of k. So like this we have. Now if a consisting the address of a of 0, what is pointer a which consisting the value? So that means if a is the address of a of 0, what is pointer a which is equals to what is the value inside of it, that is 30. That means we can say that if pointer a gives 30, that means pointer of a plus 1, a plus 1 is address of a of 1, this one, and what is the value inside of it? 20. That means we can conclude that pointer a is equals to a of 0, pointer of a plus 1 is equals to a of 1, like this. So to swap this one instead of a of 1, can I write it as pointer of a plus 1? Yes. Instead of writing a of 4, can I write it as pointer of a plus 4? Yes. So like this we need to consider, and we can swap any two elements using pointers. We'll see the code here. Of course I'm taking an array, enter the size, then enter the elements, and you can remember one more point here, ampersand of a of I you can take, or else you can consider this as a plus I, that is also as it is same. Ampersand a of I is equals to a plus I, whatever I explained right now. Now the code has to be written here, what we want to do. So we want to swap any two elements. I will take a of 1 and a of 4, so I can write this code here, or else through pointers. That's why I'll write here, instead of, I'll take one variable, that is temp variable. So temp is equals to a of 1 can be represented as pointer of a plus 1, pointer of a plus 1 is equals to pointer of a plus 4, pointer of a plus 4 is equals to temp. So like this we can write, and so that you can observe what is there. After this you can print, like for loop you write for I equals to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. You can print f percent ld, you can write A of I. After this you can observe, after this statement A of 1 will have like here 60, here you will have 20. So this is what simple swapping by using pointers. Now you can observe here I have not created any separate pointer variable. Even if you want, you can create one pointer variable int pointer p, where you can write p equals to a. Now after that here you need to write pointer of a p plus 1. Here you need to write pointer of p plus 1 equals to pointer of p plus 4. Here you need to write pointer of p plus 4 equals to 10. So without taking this one also directly you can do. That's why we call arrays are one type of pointers. Remember this point, whenever you call a of is an array. Now if I ask you what is a means, this is the address of a of 0, or you call it as base address of the array. So like this you can consider. So this is what we can swap any two elements in an array using pointers. And one more thing we can observe, like you can print a of I or I of a, both are equal. So if you print a of 2, what you will get the answer 40. Even if you can print like this also 2 of a, what is 2 of a, again 40. This is also acceptable. Remember this point also. Coming to the question number 15, swapping every pair of adjacent elements in an array. So how to swap every pair of adjacent? Let us take every pair means the array consisting only even size. So that means the output should be here 30, 20 will become 20, 30. 40, 50 will become 50, 40. 60, 80 will become 80, 60. So this is what the output should be. So how to do this one? How to swap? Anyway, here it is not asked about pointers. We can do in simple manner. So what is the logic to be followed? So I'll take first two elements. That is a of I and a of I plus 1. I will swap with temporary variable. After that, what I will do is I'll increment I by 2. That means I started from 0. Now I value will become 2. Next I value will become 4, like this. If I is 0, I plus 1 is 1. So I'll swap. Next I plus equals 2. That means I value is 2. I plus 1 is 3. Next I value is 4. Then I plus 1 is 5. So like this I'll follow the simple logic so that I'll get the answer easily. So we'll see the code here. Anyway, initially I'm taking an array and temporary variable for swapping. That is a size n and array elements. Now you can observe here I equals 0, I less than n, I plus equals to 2. So why I have written I plus equals to means every time if I take I value 0, next I value will be the alternate one. That means after 0 it has to be 2, next 4, next 6, like this. Every time it has to increment by 2. So now you can see I'm taking temp equals to a of I, a of I equals to a of I plus 1, a of I plus 1 equals temp. Very simple code we can write here. So you can observe here in our example for I equals 0, 0 temp equals to, what is temp equals to? 30, a of 0, a of I means a of 0 equals to a of I plus 1, 20, a of I plus 1, that is a of 1 is equals to temp, what is there? 30. Now a of 0 will be 20, a of 1 will be 30. Now I value is 0 only. Now it goes to the loop I plus equals to, now I value will become 2. So I value is 2, a of 2 and a of I plus 1, 3. So a of 2 and a of 3 will be swapped. So 40, 50 will become 50, 40. Next I value is 4. So 60, 80 you can take. So 80, 60 it will be. Now you can see the array. Now you want to print the array. You can print it. So how to print? Simply writing the for loop for the array. I equals 0, I less than n, I plus plus. That is, you are printing the array so that you will get the answer where you can swap every pair of adjacent elements in an array. So like this you need to code. Like this you need to find the logics. Coming to the question number 16. Rotate the array elements k times. So if I take n number of elements in an array, let us suppose I'll take the elements like this 30, 20, 40, 50, 60, 80. So where I'll take this as an array where it consists 6 elements. Now I want to rotate it k times. So I can rotate in left or right. So we'll see how to write the logic for left rotation as well as right rotation. So first of all, we'll see how the array can be changed when you make it left rotation. So in simple, we can say that in, let us suppose if I rotate only one time, that means k value if it is 1. So what happens? K value is equals to 1. So this 30 has to go here. And then 20 has to come here, 40 has to come here, 50 has to come here, that is in A of 2, 60 has to come here, 80 has to come here. Okay, like this we need to do. So what is the logic we need to follow for this? In general, we can say that if you say the index A of in 0, in A of 0, I'm writing A of 1, in A of 1, I'm writing A of 2, in A of 2, I'm writing A of 3, in A of 3, like this. So can I say it is in A of I, I'm assigning A of I plus 1. So simply, can I assign n times? We'll see that one. So let us suppose if I write like this, and if I make I starts from 0, I up to n minus 1, then what is the problem we'll get? Like whenever you, let us suppose A of 0, if I substitute this 20 here, now what about the value 30 in A of 0? That has to be first, it needs to be shifted here. But if I make shifting this 30 here, this 80 value will be lost. So in order to avoid all these problems, I'll take a temporary variable, where temporary variable will take the value 30. Then I'll make this rotation. After that, finally, whatever the temp value, I'll store in A of 5 in this example. So like this, if I go, I won't lose any value. So first of all, we'll see that logic, how it can be rotated. If I rotate one time, what might be the result? That is a left rotation I'm talking about. In left rotation, this 20 has to come here, 40 has to come here, 50, 60, 80, and then here 30 has to come. We'll see the logic for this. First of all, I'll take an array, of course, declarations, where I've taken an array and then some temporary some variables which are required. I want to enter the size of an array. For that, I have taken the variable and how many elements you want to enter. That is the thing. That is size, we call it as. Then I'll take enter those elements. Here in our example, n is equals to 6, 6 number of elements. So what are those elements? I can enter like by for loop. So this is a simple syntax to follow when you take, when you want to read the elements in an array, where every value to be scanning here one element by one, like this. Then after reading all those elements from the input, now what is the logic that I need to write? So let us suppose, of course, I need to take the one more input also, that is k number of times I need to rotate. So let us suppose first thing, I want to write the logic for only one iteration, one time rotation. So what might be the result for one time rotation? This is the result. So I'll write the logic for one time. You can see I'll take temp equals to A of 0. That means what? Here I'll have temp value is A of 0, which is equals to, in our example, that is 30. Okay, anyway, I'll erase all this first. Now afterwards, what I'll write is I'll take a loop I equals to 0. Why? Because in A of 0, I need to substitute A of 1, I need to substitute 40, like this. That is A of 2 value. So I equals 0, I less than n minus 1. What I need to do is, it's not n, it's n minus 1. Why? Because you have to take till A of 4 only. For A of 5, there is no A of 6. So that's why till I less than n minus 1, this part you remember carefully. So where A of I equals to A of I plus 1, you can see what happens to this logic means A of I value is 0. What is 0? A of 0 equals A of 1. What is here? 20. 20 will come here. Next, I value 1. In place of A of 1, 40. Here 50. Here 60. Like this. What is A of 4? I'll substitute it as A of 5, 80. Now, what is n value? 6. 6 minus 1, 5. I less than 5 means up till 4 only it will take. A of 4 equals to A of 5. Now, it comes out of the loop. Now what you need to do, what is left over here? Here left over is a of I to be substituted. What should be written here? The value 30. Where is the value 30? It's not in a of 0. Where is that value 30? In temp. So that I'll do here. So a of I equals to temp. So like this, if I do, here you will get 30, the value. So now you can see this is a one rotation. After this, if you print an array, you will get the values like this. So this is for one rotation. So what about if I give k rotations? That means k times it has to rotate. That means here what you need to do, you need to implement whatever the logic I have written from this to this. Whatever the logic I have written, that must be repeated k times. So for that purpose, I'll write a for loop here. For, I have taken one extra j variable. So j equals to 1, how many times I need to repeat k, j less than or equals to k, j plus plus, and then open brace, and where I need to close, here I need to close. That means the process, this process has to be repeated k times, so that if I give k value as 2, means here it will be done. What is there in a of 0? 10, 20, 20 will be in temp. Now 40 will come here, 50 will come here, 60, 80 will come here, 30 will come here. Then what about this one? A of I equals to temp. Now why I have written A of I means the last value of A of I, when it comes out of the for loop, what is the last value of A of I will be definitely this one. Is it? That's what. So I is equals to n minus 1, then it comes out of the loop. So what is here? A of n minus 1. What is A of n minus 1? 5 here. What is the value to be substituted? So that's why I have written here A of I equals to temp directly. So like this, you need to follow the logic. When you go for left rotation, if it is k number of times, you can observe here k number of times. So that's why I have taken one more for loop. Of course, you can use another logics also, so many logics, but this is the best way to understand. Now coming to the right rotation. So how to make it in right rotation? So right rotation means, so let us suppose here if I write 30 should be shifted here, 20 should be shifted here, 40 should be shifted here, 50 should be shifted here, 60 should be shifted here, and 80 should come here. Now how to shift like this one right rotation? What are the changes you have to do? So you may think of here, I have written A of I equals to A of I plus 1 in left rotation. That's why here you need to write A of I equals to A of I minus 1. You see here A of 1 equals to, you can write A of 0, A of 2 equals to A of 1. But what is the problem here you will get? You see, let us suppose if I write like this statement, A of I equals to A of I minus 1. Now let us suppose A of 1 equals to 20. So A of 1 equals to A of 1 minus 1, 0. So here I need to write 30. Now if I makes 2, what I need to write? A of 2 equals to A of 1. What is there in A of 1? Is it 20 or 30? 30. So 30 will be written here. Now again A of 3 equals A of 2, 30. Like this it will come. This is the main problem you will get when you go like this. So that's why I'll go for another one. So instead of doing like this, I'll go in reverse. So here I started from 0 to n minus 1. I'll start from the last to first here. When I go to right rotation, like this you can see, in place of this sort of the logic, from here to here, I'll write this logic. Temp equals to A of n minus 1. So what is there in A of n minus 1? 80. So temp equals to 80. For I equals to n minus 1 means 5. So A of 5, of course, that is greater than or equals to 1. A of 5 is equals to A of 4. So what is I have to write in place of A of 5? A of 4. What is there? 60. Next, I should be decremented. So decrement, I value will be 4. A of 4 equals to A of 3, 4 minus 1, 3. So A of 3 is 50. Like this, 40 here, 20 here, 30 here. Now what is I value? 1. So 1 is greater than equals 1, it's over. Next I value will become what? 0. So when it is 0, it comes out of the for loop. I am writing here A of 0 equals to temp. What is A of 0 equals to? Temp. Temp value is 80 here. So this value I have written. Now you see, can I say it is one right rotation? Yes. So this process has to be repeated k times. If you want to repeat in k times, you have to write this one. For j equals to 1, j less than or equals to k, j plus plus, and repeat this process k times. So like this you can go for left rotation and right rotation. Of course you have formulae also, like some sort of formula you can use, but this is the best way to understand the logics. So this part is totally for left rotation. Remaining all the things are same to write for left rotation program. And in for right rotation, in place of this logic you have to substitute this logic. So then of course remaining things are same. So like this you need to write for rotating left and right rotations in the array which are of n elements. Coming to the question number 17, sum of elements in an array. So an array is given. So let us suppose this is an array where I want to get sum of the elements in an array. So in simple, what is the sum means? I have to check for whether this is a of 0 plus a of 1 plus a of 2 up to a of n minus 1. Like this we can take. Now of course how to write the logic we'll see, and not only that we'll see only sum of even numbers in your program, in your array, and sum of only odd numbers, sum of positive numbers, sum of only negative numbers, sum of only prime numbers, how to write all those logics. So I'll just compare one logic to the another here, how to write the programs I'll explain here. Here I'm taking an array and some initialization, I'm taking some variables and also some variable sum which used for getting the sum of the elements, and it is initialized to 0, and I've taken the scanf n means size of the array. In our example it is 6, and taking those elements, what are those elements to enter. So this is the input I have taken. Now I equals 0 up to I less than n means up to n minus 1. I'm making sum equals sum plus a of I. So simply sum equals sum plus a of I means what is the sum initial value? 0. So 0 plus a of I. What is a of I? I value 0. A of 0, 30. So next, of course, this is sum is equals to 0 plus 30, that is 30. Now a of 1. What is a of 1? Plus 20. Next plus 40. Like this it will take, and finally it will give the sum, that is 280. Finally you will get the sum as 280. Is it right? So that is 30 plus 20 plus 40 plus 50 plus 60 plus 80. So this is simple logic, and finally what we need to print? Only sum. So we'll print the sum like this, and you will get the answer as 280. Now my question is, if you go for only even numbers in your array. So here of course I have taken all even numbers. Let us suppose I'll take this number as something like 25. Here I'll take something 31. Somewhere here I'll take 45. Like this. So sum of even numbers. What are even numbers? If you see 30, 50 and 60. 30, 50 and 60. 30 plus 50, 80. 80 plus 60, 140. So the sum should be 140. How you need to get this one? What is the logic you need to write? Of course the program will be same, but here you need to keep a condition, like if what you need to write, first of all you need to check whether your a of I is the even number or not. How to check even number or not? Your a of I percentile 2, I'll divide with 2. If I get remainder 0, then I can say it is an even number. Then only I'll make it sum. So otherwise I won't go for sum. That's what. Like 30 percentile 2 is 0. Yes, it will take the sum. 25 percentile 2 is 0. No, it won't take the sum. Next number. 31. It won't take. 50. Yes, it will take. 60. Yes, it will take. 45. It won't take. So 30 plus 50 plus 60. It will give the answer. Very simple. You have to do like this. If you want only odd numbers, what you need to do? Here in place of a of I percentile 2 is equals to what you need to keep here? In place of 0 you need to keep here as 1 only. If the remainder value is 1, then I can say it is a odd number. So again the same thing. Like this you need to do for even numbers and odd numbers. And what about positive numbers and negative numbers? So how to do? And for positive numbers, let us suppose this is minus 25, this is something like minus 60. So this is minus, let us suppose only two negative numbers are there. One is minus 25 and another one is minus 60. Now only what is the sum of positive elements? 30 plus 31 plus 50 plus 45. So what is the logic to be written here in place of this one? So you need to write, if I say it is a positive number, the value should be greater than 0. Is it right? So like this you need to consider. So if it is greater than 0, then only you make sum. Or else you want negative numbers. What about negative numbers? Here you need to write in place of greater than, you need to write less than. So like this you can take. And one more thing, if you take positive numbers, if you want to include 0, you can include 0 by taking a of I greater than or equals to 0. Like this. So greater than or equals to 0, you need to write here. So then like this logics you need to follow. Now, one more question. You make separate sum of even numbers and separate sum of odd numbers. Then you have to take two variables. One is sum, another one is, let us suppose you have to take sum to again and initialize to 0. So comma you can keep and keep semicolon here. Now what is the logic that you need to write? If a of I percentile 2 is 0, sum equals sum plus a of I. If it is not even, what you need to write? Else part. Else sum 2 is equals to sum 2 plus a of I. So like this you need to write. So you have to get here, sum means it will get even sum. Sum 2 means you will get odd sum. That means sum of only odd numbers, sum of only here even numbers, like this. And similarly for positive and negative values, what you need to do? If a of I is greater than 0, sum equals to sum plus a of I, where you will get the positive numbers. Else sum 2 equals to sum 2 plus a of I. So the logic in place of this, you need to write this logic. That's it. So like this you need to change the logic, you need to change your program with respect to the question. Now the last question is sum of prime numbers in an array. Let us suppose if this is an array, what are the prime numbers? 7 is a prime number, 31 is a prime number, 29 is a prime number. I want to get the sum of only these three. So what is the logic that you need to write here? So in order to get the prime number, we will check with one logic. That is, of course you can have one logic by using a inside loop checking with each number in between 1 and that number. But here we can take a simple logic that if you are thinking a number is a prime number or not, prime number, then it should not be divisible by 2, 3, 5 and 7. It should not be divisible by 2, 3, 5, 7. So we'll write that logic. Here we'll write, if the given a of I percentile 2 is not equals to 0, and that is double and logical operator, a of I percentile 3 is not equals to 0, and a of I percentile 5 is not equals to 0, double and a of I percentile 7 is not equals to 0, then I can say it is prime number. You can see for any number, of course it is the constraint applicable only the numbers after 7. So for the numbers 2, 3, 5, 7, it's not applicable. So anyway, this logic is applicable for the numbers greater than 7. You can write inside one more logic that if the number is either 2 or 3 or a of I is 5, a of I is 7. So then also we need to accept this logic. So like this you need to get the logic for prime number. So this is the one logic we can write when you don't want to use the loop when you find whether the given number is a prime number or not. So like this it will be applicable. So like this we can find the some of the elements in NRI with like different constraints like even numbers, odd numbers, positive numbers, negative numbers, and prime numbers. We'll see some more questions in the next video lecture.
If you have any queries, you can post me to this mail ID through Facebook and Gmail. Thank you.